Hi, this is Alex and welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about the Sigma 17 to 50 millimeters f2.8 EX DC OS. That's optical stabilizer. In today's video we're gonna test this lens for sharpness, barrel distortion, vignetting, and in the end we'll take all this into account and see if this is the right lens for you. Well, let's start by first looking at the package. With it comes packed in this little pouch which can hold the lens with this lens hood included in the package. It's a petal shaped. This is very nice for keeping the flare out, and you should definitely use it, especially if you shoot against the bright light or against the sun. I did use a very wide lens without using this lens hood, and it kept a lot of flare in. So do use this, as this is very important. The lens cap, pretty big, because it has to cover this huge front glass. It does have a metal mount. It feels pretty nice in the hand. It's made out of plastics, but it's pretty good quality plastics. It comes with these switches, so the optical stabilizer switch on off, pretty stiff but good in my opinion. Also pretty stiff this autofocus, manual focus switch. Pretty important if you wanna use manual focus. You don't have full manual focus, and the focus ring is connected to the motor. So in order to not wreck the motor, you should turn it to manual before trying to use the manual focus. What next? It has this, you can see it here, this tiny lock. So if you use this, you are able to lock the zoom in place. So now you're not able anymore to zoom, but important, you can use this only with a lens of 17 millimeters. If you try to use this switch at any other focal length, you won't be able to use this, as you see right here. Only 70. So as I said, this is made out of plastics, but quality plastics, and it's coated with rubber. It feels really nice in the hand. It's pretty solid build, a little heavy, 500 and something grams, but it's what you would expect of a zoom lens of constant aperture of 2.8. It's a lot of glass in here. The zoom ring feels pretty nice when operating. If you want to use manual focus, it's pretty short. I think it's built for using on autofocus mainly. So this is a really good choice if you want to upgrade from the kit lens, because of the fast f2.8 aperture, which lets in a lot of light in, nearly 2 times more light at the wide end, 17, and almost 4 times the light at the 50 millimeters length. So let's see how this lens came out in tests in the next part of this video. Next, let's see the sharpness. At 17 millimeters, f2.8, very sharp in the center and a little soft on the corners, but acceptable, I would say. Next, moving on to f4, the corners get very sharp and same quality in the center. f5.6, again very good performance in the center, and a little increase in sharpness in the corners. f8 and f11, same performance in the center and also in the corners. So a little soft at 2.8. Moving on to 21 millimeters, f2.8. Again, some softness in the corners, which gets better when we step down to f4. We can see that in the center, the sharpness it's great at all apertures, but the corners suffer quite a bit at 2.8. If we step down to f4 at all focal lengths, the corners get decent sharpness. Moving on to 28 millimeters and 35 millimeters, we can see the softness in the corners. It's a little better, but still present, very noticeable. So you do have to step down at least to f4 to get a decent sharpness in the corners. At f8, the sharpness is good, quite excellent in the corners also, and pretty same performance for f11. Yes, good sharpness, maybe a little softer now in the corners at f11. 35, very good. We can see that the sharpness in the center, it's great. All focal lengths, all apertures. But do take into consideration that to get tack sharp corners in all focal lengths, you need to step down from that 2.8. For this test, we used an ISO of 1600, and we did use a tripod to be sure we don't get handshake in the footage, so we can concentrate on the lens sharpness. So finishing sharpness test,
at 15 millimeters and f/11. I would say it's above average performance. Moving on to barrel distortion and vignetting, we see a very strong vignetting at 17 millimeters, f/2.8, but that gets very well improved at f/4. The vignetting is still present at 2.8 all the way up to 28 millimeters.
An important feature of this lens is also its optical stabilization. You can get good photos at speeds of less than 1/10 of a second, even at 50 millimeters. And this is pretty important, I would say, to get good photos in low light conditions. And also, if you are using it for doing video, this too will help you.
So, as a conclusion, I think this lens is a very good choice for the Canon APS-C camera owners, as it is a standard zoom, fast lens with image stabilization and very good price-performance ratio. If you did like this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Until next time, bye-bye!